Did you know that a new digital identity is coming for all European citizens? Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Hello Trust, your one-stop podcast dedicated to the world of digital trust, a set of innovative technologies that allows us to perform complex operations directly online, such as signing a digital contract, opening a bank account, or even subscribing an insurance policy. I'd like to remind you that this podcast has been produced by InfoCert, the largest qualified trust service provider in Europe, and you can watch all the episodes through our YouTube channel or even listening to it through your favorite podcast platform. Together with me in this journey, a real guru for EIDAS 2, Igor Marcolongo. Ciao, Igor.
Ciao, Pasquale, and hi, everybody who is listening.
Today, with us, a legal tech expert that will lead us in this journey of digital identity wallet, Lorenzo Piatti. Ciao, Lorenzo.
Hello, ciao, Pasquale.
So let's start talking about this wallet. But Igor, is that really possible to have a new identity for all European citizens?
Well, the wallet is the real big news, the big change that the new EIDAS regulation will bring to Europeans. Let's start from the basics. What's a wallet? The wallet is, simplifying a lot, an app into the, let's say, mobile phone of citizens. It is not a legal requirement that it is a mobile wallet, but it's quite likely that it will be like this, that will contain two elements. Personal identity data, the acronym is PID, so the digital identity of the wallet owner, and attributes. So a lot of additional information that we will delve into it in a while. Why the wallet? For two reasons. We know that EIDAS regulation, the acronym is EID, Digital Identity and Signatures. The component EID works differently in the various member states. In Italy, for example, there is SPID, there is the identity card, two systems that are working properly and are creating a lot of value for citizens, public administration, and so on. In other countries like Germany, for example, with Personalausweis, we had a lot of investments, but unfortunately, the uptake of the usage of this digital identity is not sufficient for the ambitious plan of that government. In other countries like Spain, for example, we don't have a real proper diffused digital identity system, mm-hmm. So there are other tools. So the European Commission decided to find a way to harmonize all these identity schemes. Okay. And the wallet, thanks to the technological evolution that in the meanwhile creates new possibilities, seems to be the right choice, or at least the state of the art in terms of digital identity to put together all these systems and create a new unique digital identity for the Europeans.
So I will have my app with my personal data, but what will be the main feature of this wallet, Lorenzo?
This is Pasquale, is a very good question, and it helps me to explain the real game changer in the wallet, which will allow you to have your real digital identity, not what we have today, that is only your name, surname, and maybe tax identification number, mm-hmm. or identity document. But it will bring all the information about you. For example, if you have a title, you are a lawyer, or you have a specific degree, or you attend a specific course, and you can have all this information in form of attributes inside the wallet, inside your app, and you can spend them to whoever is interested in it.
Wait, but how can I be sure, and who is going to certify this kind of information, Igor? Because if I'm a lawyer, who is going to certify within the wallet that I'm a real lawyer?
Okay, we are referring to the qualified attestation of attributes, okay. Or the simple attestation of attributes. We will have two different level of trust, even regarding these attributes, these additional information. The qualified attestation of attributes will be issued by qualified trust service provider that will identify you, collect the information, vet it, so check against the authentic source. Okay. For example, who says that you are a lawyer? lawyer, your bar, of course. The QTSP can bring this, the info, and go and check in order to validate it with the bar, and then create and sign the attribute in order that this information is valid into your wallet. Okay, one thing that I think it is important to underline to avoid scary situation, and the keyword is selective disclosure. Because, you know, if you have an app with all this information that are true, somebody can think, oh, wow, this could be a problem because everybody can have my data, and this can be...
Or my life, actually.
Yeah, can steal all my life. No, this is not the case. The wallet is exactly against that, because with selective disclosure, you can choose to select only the portion of information that you need, that you want to share with that specific the specific counterpart that is asking for you, knowing exactly which is the information and who is the person that you are asking it for. So, and having given your track in order even to execute your GDPR rights, if you want.
So I will have all the control of my personal data.
Yes, this is the purpose of the wallet. So you will have control, mm-hmm. security, trust, and this will unlock a lot of new use cases.
I'm curious about these new use cases because, you know, with this certified identity, with a lot of information, you know, around my person, how much potential business is here?
Well, actually, there is a lot of use cases and business potential businesses behind the wallet. You can think, for example, for the public administration, mm-hmm. as well, all the certification I need to provide to when I start, I ask a service to the public administration, maybe for the school, or maybe I need some tax exemption or these kind of things. Today, I have to provide a lot of certification, a lot of even paper. But
paper documents, actually.
Yes, but still maybe not so smart digital documents. So a PDF or something. In this new world of the digital wallet, I will have everything on my wallet, on my app, and my attributes, and I can spend them to obtain that specific service. Or think even a company, how a company can fasten the onboarding of a new supplier, and maybe not ask every time the same documents, because the supplier itself can easily spend their attributes. So this is not only for the physical person, but also for the entities, for the companies as well.
So we can easily say that we will create a kind of more trustworthy world with this identity.
Yes, totally, totally. And it's not today, but it's not so far. Because, you know, with the new EIDAS, now there are running out a lot of different projects, mm-hmm. called the Large Scale Pilot, that are piloting the wallet. And the member states and the European Commission are working hard in having all the regulation for it. Some member states are even running ahead. It's super recent that Italy is launching the ET wallet. It is not yet the EUDI wallet, so the one for Europe, but it will be an intermediate phase that then will converge there. So a lot of initiatives around the wallet. I believe that we can have it in our pockets, in our phones, by the end of 2026, or 2027, okay? And then there will be a strong real uptake to create a new digital world.
So I'm really looking forward to have my personal EUDI wallet in my pocket. Thank you very much, Lorenzo, for staying with us, and thank you very much, Igor. We will meet in the next episode. We will talk about electronic signature.
Perfect. I'm ready for that.
Be prepared, and thank you very much, you all, for watching us. You can rewatch all the episodes in our YouTube channel, or if you want to listen to them, just choose your favorite podcast platform. Thank you, and have a good day.